there was a requirement to delete some entries from the one custom database table. What I did, I wrote a statement in the program to delete the entries from that particular custom table. But when I debugged that program and I reached to that delete statement and I executed that delete statement and I went in that table in SE69 and I checked, the data is still available there. But after 2-3 line of execution, I went there and checked again. Now data got disappeared. What can be the reason? Is it database taking that much time to execute the delete statement? Or there is some other reason? Today, we'll talk about database LUW and SAP LUW, how it is behaving when we are running a program. Not only that, we will check that how state update task local statement is behaving during the updates. At last, we will create our own sales order and we will see how the update is happening in behind, how the V1 and V2 function modules are executing in what priority sequence. Let's get started. I have created one program, G Practice Update FM. I took the reference of one of the standard program, Demo SAP LU Update Task. I would have shown this program and I would have shown this concept of SAP LUW and database LUW, but I want to make some changes in this program and show you the real time how it is happening. So that is the reason I created my own program. If you want to experiment with the update function module and how this SAP LUW and database LUW is happening, you can go through that program. That is a very good program, I can see. So inside this program, I have one demo local class. Inside this local class, I have an static method main, which I am calling in my startup selection event. So if I will go to in this main method, what I am doing, I'm simply deleting data from one of the table, demo update table is there. I want to show you this table. Inside this table, we have four columns. One is ID, column 1, column 2, column 3, and column 4, along with one key field, ID. If you want to see the data in this table, you have to do FH. You can see there is three data, X, Y, Z, with some values in the columns. But I want to open this table in SE69 separately so we can see frequently even we are debugging. Okay, in separate session means SE16 and I want to see this table, not really more table, demo update table, and let me execute same data. We will see what we are seeing in clips. So what we will do, what this program is doing, it's a deleting the data from this program, then again it is updating some new entries in this program. As of now, we can see three data, 101, 110, and 120. I will update column 1 with some data, new data. I want to update 200, 210, and 220 here itself in column 1. And I want to activate this program. So it will update with new data. It will delete older data, and it will update the new data, and we will display newer data in this screen using utility class, CLDemoOp. Output. So let me execute this program. F8, I already put breakpoint on the 41. You have to double click here, then the breakpoint will be put, and I have to do F8. It will switch to ABAP retrospective. This is ABAP, sorry, it is switched to debug retrospective. We were in ABAP retrospective, it automatically came to debug retrospective. And we are now debugging our code. I will do F5 here. And what I'm doing, I'm deleting the code, deleting the data from the demo update table. Delete demo update table. There will be no data after deleting the data from this table. So just think, if I will do F5 here, If I will check the data in the data, this table, there will be data will be gone. Is it? Let me show you. No, the data is still available. Even I did apply, I executed this delete statement, data is still available. Why it is happening? I deleted, I ran this statement, delete from this data, everything, whatever the data is available in this table, delete the data. But data is still available in the database. Why? The concept of database LUW come here. Until and unless database LUW will be not closed, the data will be not update in the database. When the database LUW will be closed, either through implicit database commit or we are writing commit work ourselves. When will happen the database commit, implicit database commit? When we are calling some different program, call transaction, or we are calling some screen, call screen, this kind of statement triggering new screen. So that due to that, the database commit will happen. Otherwise, database commit will not happen, as we already know. So this wait statement also one of the cause of data implicit database commit. So as soon as this wait statement will trigger, the implicit database commit will happen. So since the implicit database will commit will happen, then database LUW will be closed and data will be updated in the database. So after this statement, if I do F5 here and I will check the data in the database or in our table, the data is gone. Boom. Yeah. So sometimes this happens real time also. So when you execute the program, then you are thinking, I deleted this data. Why it is not deleting from the database? And after a few line of codes, we again check. Now it got deleted. How it happened? If our concepts are not clear, this will happen with us. Then we think might be the database is taking much time to update this data. Is it not the case? So our concepts, if you know about already database LUW, when the data will be updated, then you will be sure. Oh, since this wait statement trigger, that is the reason our database updated here. Not up. Even I write a lot of statement in between here, which is not causing the database, implicit database commit. Or increase the database LUW close. So in this case, the data will be not updated. And since this statement got triggered, due to that, our data got updated in the database. Same goes here. If I created one internal table, which is the type of table type of this demo update table. Demo update table, table type is demo update table. And using that, I use new syntax to push the entries in the table. I entered three entries, new entries here. If I do F5 and I'm here inserting this internal table values to the main table, database table. If I do F5, what do you think? The data will be there here. I did F5, but data is still not came here because database LUW is still open. As soon as here the database LUW will close due to the wait statement, the new database LUW will be open. And in this new database LUW, we have written this insert statement and still it is open. Even this statement executed, our values will be not updated in the database. So to update the data with either we have to close this database LUW explicitly using the commit work statement, or whenever the some statement will trigger where the implicit database commit will happen, it will automatically close it out. So here I wrote the commit work explicitly to close the database LUW. The commit work statement not only close the database LUW, it will close the SAP LUW also. This will, SAP LUW will discuss in a while. As of now, we are discussing database LUW. So since we are closing this database LUW, and the data will be updated in the database. You can see, after this, I'm getting the data from the database. And I'm displaying this data. Oh, sorry, I did F5. So no need to go F6 and F6 data got displayed now. So I hope you understand this database LUW, how it is working this database LUW. Let me close it and switch to ABAP perspective. And let me go to the program. So now the requirement is like that. I'm deleting the data from the demo update. I'm inserting it back again. Suppose in between these two statements, line number 20, if we have one error message, let me write it down, this error message, Control C, Control V, some error message I can write down. Okay, after the committing this, after the implicit database commit happen, there is an error message, and then we are inserting and then we are doing other changes. Let me do Control F3. So what will happen? If I execute now my program, since the debugger perspective will open, and if I do F5, I can see demo update table. Let me refresh it out. There is the data. But if I do wait up to 1 second, it will delete data, since implicit database commit will happen. There will be no data now. And if I display error message, then program will terminate. And program come out from the screen, and now other statement will be not executed. Like that it will happen. But my requirement is like that. Let me switch to ABAP perspective again. If something goes wrong in between this insertion and deletion, I don't want to delete that data. Means either I want to do this deletion and insertion operation altogether, or I don't want to do at all. It should not be happen like I deleted this table and I'm not able to insert the data again in database, like it is happening. I deleted the table, but I didn't insert the data again. So in this case, what we can do, this database LUW concept will not work for you, because we have to collect these changes and we have to do these changes all together. We can't do these changes at the different places of different program. So that is the reason we have to collect these changes in SAP LUW. This delete statement should be written in the SAP LUW. And this insert statement also should be written in the SAP LUW. And this SAP LUW will be called after the commit work, and it should be executed all the changes together or not a single change. How we can collect the changes in the SAP LUW? So we are using the bundling tactics. So one of the bundling technique is SAP update function module. So we'll use update function module to delete this table and insert the entries in this table, and those update function module we will call together. How we will do? Let's see. I have already some code. Let me call. There is one function module. Let me call before this. Instead of this delete statement, Control F less than Control F3. I'm calling this demo update delete. What it will do? Let me open this function module for you guys. And let me open it parallelly. You can see what it is doing. It is the getting the values from internal table values, and it is deleting those values from this demo update. If the values is initial, it is deleting the entire table. So in this case, we are not passing any values. We are just calling this function module in update task. And in this case, what it will do, it will delete entire this table. If you see this function module, if I want to see what kind of this function module, where I can see, I have to open it up the properties view. Inside the properties view, we can see normal properties, what it is active version or not, what package it is written in, what is the description. If I want to see the what kind of this function module, this is RFC function module or normal function module, update function module, that I can see in the specific tab of this properties view. If I go to a specific tab, I can see what kind of this function module, what is the processing type. Since it is update, it is written update. If it is normal, we can select from here. So since it is update, and now we want to change what kind of update function module it is. It is a start immediate, or it is immediate start, no restart, start delayed, or it should be run through collective run program RSM 1300 program. Okay, so this to our V1 and this is V2 update and this is collective run. So currently it is start immediate means V1 kind of update function module. Same way what I will do, I will replace this insert statement with another update function module. I have another, this is also a standard function module. As I told you, I took reference from the existing standard program. So I'm doing control shift greater than to uncomment this changes. I don't want this line now, control shift less than. And you can see now I'm using this update function module, demo update insert to update the data or insert the data in this table. Let me activate and show you this assignment as well. Let me open this up, demo update insert, control click, and you can see this is also, if I will go in specific properties of this function module, this is also update function module and V1 type of function module. Inside this, I'm just inserting the data in this table. I'm calling, instead of directly calling insert statement, I wrote this insert statement in one function module. I made that function module as an update function module. Let me close it out, both the function module. Okay, let me minimize this. If you are not able to see this properties view of this particular program, you can go to Windows. You can open show view. There is something called properties view. You can click here. It will open it up for you. Suppose I close it. I want to show you how it will open again. Let me click here. It will open here. Like that, we can open any kind of view. So this is the way we can open in the view and we can adjust according to our requirement in this ABAP perspective. Let me minimize this. So you can see instead of calling the delete statement and insert statement, we are calling the update function module. So we will execute this program and see how it is behaving now. We can see as of now, there is no data in this table. The data is blank. Let me remove this error message. Now it is not required. Control shift less than control F3. Let me activate this program. Data is already not there. Then how it will update? Let me execute once without doing anything. I will do F8. So as of now, the update debugging is not on. So what I will do, F8. It will not open any another session and it will just execute the program. First, I want to get some data in the table. So I can see there is some data in the table now. Now let me execute again this program. What I will do, I will go to ABAP perspective. Let me execute this program line by line and I will show you how this is behaving now. I'll do F5. Since this function module is update function module and it is called in update task, if I will do F5 here, what will happen? It will not go to inside this function module. Instead of, it will skip this function module and register this function module to update to run after the commit work. Let me do F5. This is the F5 button. It didn't execute it at all. Whatever the statement returned inside the function module didn't execute it. Instead of this function module got registered to run after commit work. Even this wait statement is running and database commit is happening now and database LUW is closing. Since we didn't execute a delete statement, nothing will delete from this table. Let me show you. See, data is available still, even after refresh. Because our delete statement is written inside this function module and this function module is not executed yet. Same way, I'm inserting the values in this internal table and I'm doing F5 again for this function module. This function module also not executed since it is update function module and it's running. It will run after this commit work. So both statement will after run, both the function module will run after the commit work. Now I am doing commit work. As soon as I do commit work, the another session will open. That session will execute update work process. This is currently we are running dialog work process since we are interacting with screen. And as soon as commit work will happen, the another work process, update work process will open. To see that update work process, we have to switch on update debugging. In the Eclipse, to switch on the update debugging, we have to click here, ABAP debugger access, and we have to switch on the update debugging. As soon as we switch on the update debugging, and after the commit work, it will open new session. Not like SAP's UI where we are opening exactly new screen at all. It will appear here itself. Let me show you. I will do F5 again. As soon as I do F5, the update process started. You can see the update process is started and the RSM13000 program will run this update. All the update will be run through this program only. And our first function module called demo update delete. Now this delete statement will execute. Now I will go and check the data. The data is still not deleted. As I told you, this database LUW didn't close. I will do F5 and another function module got called. I will refresh it out. This data is not deleted. Since we are still in same SAP LUW and same database LUW also, because we are placing that SAP LUW inside the database LUW. That is the reason that database LUW didn't close yet. And our SAP LUW running inside the database, single database LUW. And both the function module inside the SAP LUW, that is the running, they are running one by one. And there is nothing is written in between something which caused the database implicit commit. That is the reason we always tell we should not write forbidden statement inside this function module, update function module, which will cause the implicit database commit, like commit work or some calling different screen or those kind of statements you should not write. So I do F5 here. Now it got, the data should be deleted and inserted altogether, or it will be not done. If I will do F8, the data will be deleted and it will be updated in the table again. So how it is happening in backend, I just want to show you that. If you open this program, RSM1300 program, so you can see this is running, this is main program. Inside the main program, they are calling one module will be execute. Inside this module, we have one perform, we have case statement based on the update, what phase it is. It is V1 update phase or V2 update phase, what kind of it? Since it is V1 phase, we are running this V1 normal. You can see the value 01 and we are running this function module 01. So that is the reason it is all the V1 update will be run first. Inside the VB V1 normal perform, if you go inside, so you can see there is one select statement is written inside this VB V1 normal, that is, it is getting the data from the VBHDR table with this key. Let me see the value of this key. If I open this table VBHDR, anyway, you got it, Control C, this data will be, if you see data in this, there is already one data, it is coming from with this VB key. There is select statement. As I told you, for each update request, there will be one line of entry in VBHDR. We will, after the commit work, we will give the data from these tables. So this data will be saved whenever we are calling this update request. And after the commit work, as soon as will commit work will trigger, the VBHDR table will be updated. That is the reason we are getting the data now. When we are really processing the update in the update work process, first we got the data from VBHDR database table and the VB mode table. I just want to show you what kind of data will be available in the VB modes. So SS16, and let me show you VB mode table. Inside the VB mode table, we will be having all the, with this key, all the function module. For each function module, there will be one entry. and you can see the entries in this table. There is one another table called DB data, I think so. So we have to pass this key and execute. So there will be the other detail. This is the for each function module, we are having this detail in the encoded format, which will be stored in the database in the encoded format, and we will get, this is nothing but interface things, which we can see here. Interface data in the form of the encoded DB data is the data which we pass to the database. Suppose here we are deleting the data in the internal table we passed, that will be encoded in, saved in the VB data table, in the VB data field, and we will get the data from here. How we are getting? First, we go to the VB header table, and that detail we are passing to this V1 execution perform. And inside this VB V1 execution, we are looking through the one table called VB mode table. You can see VB mode table. If you see this table data, let me open it up here. So you can see the demo update, delete, and demo. This data we got from the VB mode table, which is the database table. I just now I showed you VB mode table, both the entries, and it is looping through one by one this function module, and this function module called here, as you can see currently. Where it is? Let me click over here. It is here. Inside the loop, we are having VB called this function module with this VB key. If you go further deep in this perform, this function module will be called first. What is the data in this demo update insert, because it's second statement, and this function module called in this program. This program is nothing, this is function group of this particular this function module, and we are calling, coming to this function module. And first function module was called, then second entry was the insert, then second function module called. Like that it is happening in this behind in the update work process. Whenever the update is called, this RSM 13000 program will be called, and we are running one by one all the update function module, like you can see. Let me do FH. The update got triggered. It came out from this commit work, and this got terminated. Update work process got closed, and this session also closed. And if again I'm getting the data from this updated data from this table, it got updated data. Same data we are updating, that is the reason there is no change. And we can see the result after displaying. This is the data, okay? So like that, this data will be displayed using the function module. We are achieving the SAP LUW concept. We are bundling the all the changes inside this function module, and those function module will be called after the commit work, and those function module will be placed in the single database LUW to execute. Our changes are happening together or not at all. Even we are writing some error message here, it will not impact, because let me uncomment this line again. And since this, there is no deletion happened before this error message, because deletion and updation we are doing after commit work, and so that is the reason this, the data will be not deleted at all if some error occurred in between this two function module. Let me activate it, Control F3. Let me execute F8. Debug perspective will off one. Let me do F5. So again, this function module didn't execute it. Nothing got updated in database table. You can see the same data we are getting. So as you can see, same data. So even we are getting error, there will be no impact because it didn't delete anything. So our requirement we achieved. Either we are doing both the things together or not we are doing single thing. That is the way we will achieve all the changes, and we will maintain the data consistency in the database using the SAP LUW. So for us, the database LUW is not sufficient because it is closing every time this database commit is happening. So that is the reason SAP came up with SAP LUW concept, and we are achieving the data consistency using the SAP LUW. So to to giving the difference between the different type of the task, start immediate, immediate start, no start, restart, start delayed. I want to give you one real-time example. When the V1 update will run and when the V2 update will run, how to make those differences, so how it is happening in behind the system. We will create one sales order and we will see how system it is updating real-time. Let me create one sales order. Let me minimize this. Let me close this session. So any T code, if you want to open in Eclipse, Alt-F8. I want to create one sales order. Let me do VA01. So I will give you order type OR. Let me enter. I will give sell to party 1, ship to party 1, some reference, test order, test R underscore Y. Some reference I can give. I will give one material number and order quantity. I can give anything 10. And let me click enter. The sales org data I will select first one. After selecting sales org data, it is saying PR00 is missing. Let me go to line item condition record and add this PR00 condition and give some value 12. Let me click enter. Let me come back. Now I'm saving the sales order. Whenever I save the sales order, then first it will normal dialog box process will trigger and it will save the sales order. After everything is done, whatever the data we entered throughout the different screens, I went into different screens. As I told you, when we are going from one screen to another screen and entering some data, we are not saving those data directly in the database. So at different places, the update function module called in backend whenever we are entering some data. So now as soon as I save, finally, I'm telling the system everything is okay. I want to save my data. That time, then one new update work process will be called. All the save those function module will be called one by one. Let me show you. Let me switch on the debugging. Place there. When I will save this one, you can see my debugger got on. First, this one is the normal debugging, dialog work debugging. So to make sure that my update debug also will be called after this dialog processing, so I have to click go here and switch on the update debugging. As soon as I switch on my update debugging, and I'm not interested as of now in my dialog debugging. I just do F8. My everything is done in my dialog debugging, and my update debugging is called in another session. Here we can't see another session. This will be clipped, so that is the reason you can see in the stack. First, this for the dialog one, and second, this for the update debugging. In the update debugging also, you can see one function module, rvsales.document.aid. This is called. So how it is calling? How many function modules in backend will be called in the update task? To see that one, as I told you previously, we have to go in the V1 actual. So I have to see the loop and I have to double click on the VB mode tab. So as you can see, there is so many function modules there, which is called in update because it's sales order, it's a big process. I think 10 function module is called in backend. The VB mode is the criteria. One means V1 and three also V1. And two is the V2. What is the difference between three and one? One is V1 means start immediately. Three means start immediately, but no restart. We can't update, we can't rerun this transaction through SM13, something goes wrong. But one is re-updatable. So that is the reason this three and one will be called first. These are the priorities function module. And after executing the all V1 function module, then V2 function module, which is marked as a two, that will be called. So that is the reason. Let me take a small screenshot of this VB mode table. Okay. It will be okay and minimize it. As of now, it is not required. As of now, I have to put somewhere breakpoint is already available. First time the system breakpoint didn't trigger, let me put some of the breakpoint over there inside the loop and VB function module. Okay, now this function module call, first function module in the this one in our stack, because it was a this is not called this. Let me put in that project. This one is not called because it is V2 update. Okay, since it is V1 update, and this is also V1, 3 also V1, 1 also V1. But difference between 3 and 1 is that one is not restart and one is restartable. So wherever it is written 1, it is restartable update function module, and 3 is not restartable function module. Okay, let me do F7. I'm not interested what these function modules are doing as of now. Let me do F7 for this function module. As soon as I do F7, so this function module got executed and we came out from here. Just let me do once again F7. So we are inside the loop, as you can see. We were processing second entry. I will process now third entry inside this loop, F5, where we are looping this VB mode table. You can see how many entries is there. All total 10 entries is there. I am Sitebix. If you want to see, you can enter Sitebix. So as of now, Sitebix is on F5. I will do this is third entry. Third entry, what is the function module name you want to see? There is, we can see function module name also. VB funks, double click. You can see NCV statics. This is the V1 kind of update which is restartable. If I do F5, then it will come here. Since it is V1 type of function module, this will go inside this perform. If it is V1 or this update, VB mode is either 3 or 1, otherwise it will not go. You can see VB1 either 1 or either it should be 3, then only it will go, otherwise it will not go. And VB state, as of now, you can see this VB state, VB SDR, VB state 255 for each and every entry, because it didn't get executed at all. So that is the reason. It should not be 1, 2 or 3. If it is already processed, it will not go inside. So that is the thing it is checking. So in this case, it is not processed since it is 255 and it is VB mode is 1. It will go and perform this one. VB call, this function module is going to call. Which function module? MCV. If I go inside this perform, you can see a lot of they are updating some parameter and they are calling this function module. They are getting first the function group name for this function module, and after that this function, along with this function group name and function module name, they are calling this function module. How they are getting? You can see CFDIR table where they are getting the program name is function group name for this function module. Let me do F8. I have already breakpoint over here. You can see what is the function group name. This is the function group name and this is the function name which we already seen, UV function. This and this thing, it will be called. I will do F5, it will go inside the function module. This is the how the update processing is calling one by one all the one function module. I'm not interested in the function module. Let me do F7. So now we came out. Let me do F7. Now next loop will go, and next loop, which function module it will execute? We executed this one, MCV statics. And in order, the next function module, let me see, F5, V2 order. But this function module is, you can see V2 order, but this function module is VB mode 2. This is V2 kind of update. It will not update here. If I do F5, it will not go to that perform. If I will do F5, since it is VB2, it is updating one variable, exist V2 equal to 01. Because it VB state equal to 2, so it is telling that system, there is some function module is there, which is having the kind of V2 update. So later, after this loop, they will use this variable to update V2 function module. If there is no V2 function module at all, it will come out from this perform itself. That is the reason they are, in the same way, they are checking the if there is something ARFC, if there is something collector kind of function module, everything they are checking here itself. And after this, since this is the V2 module, and the VB mode equal to 2, it will not go inside and execute this perform. That's a very important. This RSM 13000 program, if you go and put breakpoints and see, it very important to debug. Whenever we are debugging update function module, it's giving a lot of information here. Since it will not go inside here, I will do F5. It didn't go inside, and we are going to next entry. Next entry will be empty updates CM order. F5. Now it will go inside and call this particular function module. After getting the entry from the RFC, that what is the function group name, and it will call this particular function module. I will do F8. Let me go inside and show you F5. They call this function module. Which function module? MCV update CM order function module they call. Let me do F7. I'm not interested in calling this, executing this function module. So like in the same way, it will call all the function module wherever we are getting 1 and 3. So now till here it will call 9. Let me do F8. So now this case forecast SD will be called case forecast, and after that case sales also will be called. Now it is calling case forecast F8. Now it will call case sales send to server function module F8. Now it will call next function module CRS sales send to server. That also it will called, and after this function module bal db internal in update task, that also will be called. I'm not interested in this also. This all function module is calling one by one, is in the v1 update. At last one function module is there which will be skipped, v2 f8. Now bofu, this function module came. So what happened? All the function module got executed and this function module will came. So what happened, as you know, we were having the breakpoint over here somewhere. Let me show you. It came out, not an issue. I just showed you in the code itself. Let me minimize it here. Let me decrease this also. So we were running this loop. Since the exist v2 equal to 01, it came out from here. If something error happened during v1 update, it will roll back here itself. It could not go here and it will return from here. Since there is no error was there, so in this case what it is doing, it is checking over here. This if is not required, this is not relevant for us. It is checking somewhere here that there is some this variable exist v2 is there or not. Exist arfc, there is no arfc, so no issue. Let me exist v2 there or not. If there is some v2 update function module, then only this perform will call. Inside this perform, what they will do, they will call only the v2 function module. They delete all the v1 updates, means which is vd mode equal to 1 and 3. Let me go, it came here. F5. So F6. So it is calling only these three vd, where is the vd mode equal to. First he called this function, all the function module which were v1, and now only the v2 update function module will be called one by. So that is the reason I was telling. There one more thing before the if I want to show you guys, this is they are calling only v2 updates now. Let me see one by one. Before the v2 update start, they already do one time commit work. They updated the database with the data of v1 updates. So if something goes wrong in v2 update, only the v2 changes will be revert back, not v1 changes. That is the most important thing. I explained in my theory session as well. This is important to know. If something goes wrong, if v1 executed successfully, there is nothing goes wrong, then those updated successfully. And if something goes wrong in v1 update, v2 update will be not executed. We will come out from v1 update and the v1 data also roll back. But v1 once gets successful and we are running v2 updates, that time some error we are getting, only v2 updates will be rolled back and v1 already committed in the database. That's a very important thing when we are dealing with these function modules. F5. So I would have shown you there, they are doing somewhere commit work before calling the v2 update inside somewhere here. When they are running the vb v1 execution before calling this second function module, they already committed the changes of V1 update, then only they are coming here. After this loop, they are already inside VBDo commit, inside this perform. What they did, they committed the V1 updates. Then they went for the V2 update. That's a very important thing. We can see in the programming as well. Okay, like that, it will run one by one, the all three function modules. First, they run self. Second one, they will run MCV static. And third one, they will run DFU change document. After V2 update, the V1 and V2 update is done. Collective run, if it is there, will be not executed here. It will be executed through RSM 13005 program that we have to run separately, but that will be not run by this program at all. So it will be come out after V2 update. Let me do that. Everything is done. Both the dialog work process and this, both the session, update session, both are ended, and now our sales order got saved. Or this is asking for the second sales order. Please enter soul to party, because it came out and it went to VA01 again. So like that, we can do the how we are dealing with the V1, V2 update and collective run. Collective run is very easy. After the V1, V2 update is done, it's nothing related to T code. We have to run the separate T code, the program RSM 13005 program, to run all the collective runs. In my last two video, we have discussed about update function module. If you have any doubt regarding update function module, please write it down in comment section. With that, please like this video and subscribe this channel. It will give me huge motivation to create video like this. Thank you and happy learning.